three. Okay, this is Freya von Haus Odoms, and she's lived with me for about a year. I'm getting her ready for BH and IPO1, and we've done a lot of track. She doesn't know articles yet. We're just working for commitment for the track, a deep nose, and to really have a strong desire to work for the track. So this is how we're going. So I have a flag. Let's go. So with her, I'm pyramid tracking now, which I call the Joel Monroe method. So what it is, I have 5 pieces of food at the start, then food, 3 steps no food, 5 steps no food, 7 steps no food, 9 steps no food, then I go back down to 7. So what I want is, I want to see the same consistency, the same desire for the track with or without food. Because eventually I want to start to get up so I can do like 100 paces no food and she still pulls forward, she doesn't stop, and she just works. So in Schutzen, what they grade on is a deep nose and commitment to the track. So they want to see the dog track at the same speed the whole track. So this track is about 200 paces. For Schutzen 1, the track is 300 paces. So here I have a corner coming up. I'm not seeing. I think 9 steps. No, after this. So there's a food job. Freya will get every speck of food that I've laid on the track. Here's my corner. Very good. Steps before corner, no food. Then I make a scent pad on the corner and put 1 piece of food 1 step after corner. So it teaches the dog to really have confidence on the corner. They get heavily rewarded. Here's my next corner. So you see? So I don't steer her, I let her problem solve. I make the choice to make. Notice, but when there's no food, she pulls harder. So if you have a dog who races, how to slow them down is to start putting a lot more food on the track. 9. So she's a little bit distracted with the people walking and the bikes going by because we're going right towards them. Nine. Correct her for lifting her head and looking at the people. And if you never train like this, if you go to trial, it could happen that the track's on a busy location, and if you've never trained in a hard location with lots of noise and distraction, then the dog has lots of problems and might not pass. So you can see she's getting a little bit tired, so the head's starting to come up. See that? hard on the dog. It's generally where you see the condition of the dog first. But it's so hard mentally. So I let her make a choice. There she is, her eyes. Nine. Anya got a little too close with the camera. So just use a zoom. It would work better. And then it doesn't distract her. So it's okay for a distraction like that, because if I have a perfect track, then I'm not teaching the dog anything. So I want each track to be a learning track. So there's no food up here because we're just about to the end. This is really how much she can kind of smell the article. Flats. So she doesn't really know articles yet. So I'm cooking for her to keep her head down and stay looking at that article. I don't want her looking up. I want her to just start thinking of this article. And as she gets better, I'm gonna make her wait longer and longer looking at the article. So under the rules, the dog cannot touch the article. It's got to be between their front paws. There you go. Good girl. Good girl. Yeah. Can Anya throw me the tongue toy? Look at this. Freya, Freya, Freya! Yes! Look! Oh, what a good girl! And we're just teaching her to what? Oh. Good girl! Yeah, you're so good! Okay, she's done.